four asteroids on collision course with Earth, RT's June 30th article. It's a scenario straight out of Hollywood blockbusters. An asteroid careening towards our Earth, and it's set to wipe out human existence. To mark Asteroid Day, here are four space rocks on a collision course with our planet. The United Nations fears that the possibility of an asteroid smashing into our densely populated into a densely populated area of the world is not being taken seriously enough. So it designed June 30th as International Asteroid Day, and it did this to raise awareness about the potentially catastrophic occurrence. The date was chosen because the largest asteroid impact on record took place over Tunguska, Russia, on that day, June 30th, in 1908, when an enormous asteroid exploded and destroyed hundreds of acres of forest. 1908. To mark the event, here are just four asteroids that could wallop our Earth. The first one is 1979 XB. With its 900 meter diameter, this enormous rock, if it hits our planet, the impact would be devastating. It's currently hurtling through the solar system at nearly 70,000 kilometers each hour, 70,000 per hour, and is getting almost 30 kilometers closer to every Earth every second. The European Space Agency has put it in second place on its risk list for near-Earth asteroids. The orbit of this minor planet is unreliable, but its prediction is predicted to have a chance of hitting Earth midway through this century. That's bad news, obviously. Experts warn that 1979 XB could suddenly become a lot closer to Earth, given only a tiny variation on its orbit. Its next predicted approach of Earth is set to be coming in at 2024. Now this one, the next one, is an asteroid we've all heard about, the Apophis asteroid, roughly the size of four football fields. The Apophis is in very close orbit to Earth. It's currently more than 200 million kilometers away, but gets half a kilometer close every single second that passes. It regularly passes Earth on its orbit, but the latest radar and optical data suggest we're in for a close shave when it blazes past our planet on a distance of just 30,000 kilometers. This will be taking place in about 10 years, on April 13th, Friday, April 13th, 2029, they say. This is less than a tenth of the distance to the Moon. It will next fly by Earth in mid-October this year, when it will pass us at a safe distance of around 30 million kilometers. If Apophis did blast into Earth, the impact is calculated to be similar to about 15,000 nuclear weapons detonating at once. 15,000, can you imagine? And next is the asteroid 2010 RF-12. This asteroid holds dubious honor of topping both the Sentry list, that's the Earth Impact Monitor System, and the ESA Impact Risk list. It's currently around 215 million kilometers from Earth and is traveling at a speed of 117,935 kilometers per hour. I mean, these are really, really, as you can imagine, very fast speeds. The danger from this asteroid is not forecast to come until the end of the century, when it's calculated to come as much as 40 times closer than the Moon. Luckily, it weighs a relatively small amount, only 500 tons, and is about 7 meters in diameter. The impact is forecast to be slightly less than the meter that hit the Russian city of Chelyabinsk back in February 2013, which damaged thousands of buildings and injured people. Now, asteroid 2010 RF-12 is set to pass Earth August 13, 2022, when astronomers around the world will train their telescopes on the object to learn as much as possible about it and its trajectory. Then we have asteroid 2000 SG334. 2000 SG334 is part of a group called the Aten Asteroids, A-T-E-A-N, which have orbits aligned very close with Earth. It's predicted to have a chance of impact in the next 3 or 4 decades. With just a 15-meter diameter, it's relatively small, but still twice as long as the Chelyabinsk meteor was, which caused so much damage 60 years before that. It's currently traveling through space at more than 112,000 kilometers per hour. It's getting 1,003 kilometers closer to Earth every single second. Interestingly, it travels around the Sun in almost the same exact time as Earth. It has an orbit of 353 days versus Earth's 365 days. This gives astronomers regular chances to observe the asteroid and assess the risk it poses. Now, what about undetected asteroids? Of course, a big part of the danger. Just like Chelyabinsk, nobody saw that coming in. Or the one that hit the south of the Aleutian Islands about a month ago, nobody saw that coming in. So a big part of the danger with hazardous space objects is that we are not good at detecting them, and some of the most dangerous ones have caught us by surprise. When the Chelyabinsk meteor entered Earth's atmosphere undetected, its explosion released up to 30 times more energy than the atomic bombs the U.S. dropped on Japan in 1945. As recently as last December, another asteroid broke apart over the Bering Sea that was 10 times more powerful than the bombs dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Neither near-Earth objects, NEOs, were tracked in advance, and it's hoped that International Asteroid Day will prompt authorities around the world to improve how they detect and the potentially cataclysmic space rocks from impacting our Earth. Here we are at Google Earth, and I just wanted to show you a couple of the asteroid strikes that we can see from the air. And one of them is, for example, this one here in Quebec. And you can see it pretty much from here. Can you see it? There it is. That's one of them. I'm sure there's a lot more that are smaller, but this looks to me that it's a double one, double whammy, one here and the same size right there. There seems to be another one around here, and I don't know what that is there, but we've also had something that looks like huge comet impacts. Look at this thing here. Look at that. I still don't know what Hudson Bay, the story with Hudson Bay is, but to me it looks like that is definitely some kind of an impact. This is the area of the Yucatan Peninsula where we had the dinosaur impact, asteroid impact about 66 million years ago. They said that's where it struck from what they have found there. And look at this thing here. Let's pull out so you can see. Very interesting stuff here. It's as if something like the finger of God pushed this up and stopped right there. And these are volcanic islands right there. We were recently having a very bad earthquake swarm right here in Puerto Rico. But look at this. It's as if something just slammed into it and stop right there. And we have from the west to the east, and we have the same thing down here. Look, from the west to the east, and again you have volcanic islands here at this arc right there where it stopped. You can see that right there. Isn't that strange? And it's also, it looks as if it cut this island, this landmass, and pushed it along here as it came slamming and stopping right there. It could have been that this was at one time connected. And we have another area that, well, we know that I did do a past video on Australia, has at least 50 impacts. Okay, now, if we go here, you have another one right there, look. This one came, again, from the west to the east, slamming in and stopping right there. around the Papua New Guinea area, some kind of a comet. Huge. I'm saying comet because I assume they're a lot more, they're much more massive, bigger than asteroids. Look at this. And again, volcanic islands right there. So our Earth has a lot of scars from impacts of the past. You could imagine the tsunamis that these things would have lifted and the destruction that would have been caused by these things. So yes, and we still don't have any means of protecting Earth in case of an asteroid strike, unfortunately. If you'd like to join me on my Patreon account, you will hear content not covered by mainstream media. These riveting stories will be based on my research, and I will state my opinions and give my personal insight on diverse and controversial subjects and world events, events not covered by mainstream media, and not supported by YouTube guidelines. So whatever I have on my Patreon, most of those will not be on my YouTube channel. Please consider becoming a member today. More of the most significant and important videos will be on my Patreon channel. Your support helps me to continue my research and keeps this YouTube channel alive. And we depend on your support, your generous charity, because we help economically challenged families here in Athens, Greece, and Kapota, and we also help the young generation with university tuition and the community around our church. Thank you.